G'day, welcome to Mount Cranberry Apiculture. It's Wednesday, the 26th of June, 2024. I'm just about to extract a bit of honey here. I haven't done a honey extraction video for a few years. I've been asked to do another one. My equipment's changed quite a bit since the last one. The principle's the same, but I've just upped my capacity a little bit. So there's 15 boxes here to do, which will take me most of the day. I'm in no hurry. Let's go through that process and have a look how we do it here. So looking from the flow coming in, boxes coming through the door here, there's 15 there. I just got them sitting on poly, Paradise poly lids, just to keep them off the floor contact. Next step is uncapping. So I've just got a nice old cheap fry pan. I run it on 0 to 1 just to keep the knives warm. Yeah, just a couple of cheap honey knives. I like the serrated edge ones. They're great for chopping through old brood combs if you've got those up in the honey super. Next stop is the uncapping bench. So this is a Lyson one. I think it's the biggest one you can get. So that'll more than hold what I need in a day. So there's this thing here that came with it. I've got no idea how that works, and I just use it when I cover the bench up with a clean sheet when I'm not using it, just to hold it up. I've adapted it to have the spike that I rest the frame on. You'll see that work in a second. So down on the floor is the floor of the uncapping bench is a strainer, so the cappings just fall in there. And they drain over a couple of days and run out the bottom there. The honey runs out the bottom. So from the uncapping bench, there's my coffee from the idle in, into this Lyson extractor. I think it's 24 frame. It's going really well. Just fit in there. You'll see how that works in a second. I'm thinking about bolting it to the floor. It does move a little bit. It can be hard to get it up to high speed. From there, honey gets decanted out of there into a bucket, stainless steel bucket, and I keep that bucket in a plastic tub. One, to eliminate floor contact, and two, if it overflows, you've got a little bit of leeway there. How do I know? I've overflowed bucket after bucket on this floor, and it's so there's a tip for you. Put your buckets in a larger tub. I've upped my settling capacity up the other end, so they're Lyson settling tanks as well, 200 litres each, so that's about 600 kilos capacity there. And I'll show you how that works as well. So let's go through that extracting process and we'll show you how it's done. So just loosen these frames up. I don't think this box has been extracted before, so let's see how we go. Nice frame there. It's not 100% capped, but everything is ready to go. So frame just goes on the spike there. Get a warm knife. And just slice those cappings off. I'll have a few that aren't taken off. Just get my honey scratcher and capping scratcher on there. Whip it off, change knives. Other side off. Get those few cappings that I've missed. That's it. So that can sit there and wait till I start filling the extractor. Let's do another one. That warm knife just helps get through those cappings. There's other ways of uncapping. I really like getting these frames nice and even back to these bars. That way I can either change these frames anywhere I want in the hive. Just makes life a little bit easier. Capping's a scratch. Make sure we can get all the honey out of that frame. So I can fill that bench right up with frames. I just like to start stacking the extractor straight away. So I'll just move that camera around to get a better angle. These radial extractors, they just go in like that. I'll just start here, going like this, and they spin and the honey's thrown out towards the outside of the extractor. They just fit in there nicely. Keep uncapping and fill that extractor. Right, so we're ready to go. We've got our 30 frames in. What I do as well is mark the first frame that went in. Because I run a barrier system, I make sure that the same frames go back in the same boxes and the same boxes go back on the same hive. So it just minimises the risk of transmitting disease. So that's the first frame that went in. So I will unpack this in reverse order and put those frames back in their correct boxes. So I don't understand how people tell me they can't run a barrier system, it's too complicated. It's a very simple process if you just look at the layout of your extracting plant and just work out the correlation and try and get those same frames back in the same boxes, and you'll go a long way to minimising spread of disease in your hives, particularly American fowl brood. So let's get this started and get this honey extracted. So these lysine extractors have got programs and it'll run over a 9-minute period or something. I've never found them any good. If someone has worked out how to change them or adapt them, let me know in the comments. But I just like to do it the old fashioned way. I started out nice and slow and just pick up the speed until I start to get honey coming out. Just takes a little while to balance it, particularly if, like this load, there's different types of frames and not every frame is full of honey. So just got to get it running and get it balanced and just start to get that honey to come out. I can hear it coming out now. Just hear it hitting the sides of the extractor. So that's on 30% now, still nice and stable. So whatever it's balanced and stable, I just bump the speed up a little bit. It's 5% increments. So I can hear the honey coming out and hitting the side of the extractor now. I had the fan heater on these boxes last night as well, just to warm it up nicely, just to get that honey to flow out. If they were cold, it'd take a lot longer and you wouldn't get a great yield on them. So that's on 50% now. Just see it starting to wobble. Give it another little hit. So yeah, that's wobbling a bit too much. I'll just back it back to 50 and let it run for 5 minutes and just get all those frames to even up, and then I can speed it up a little bit later. So that's running nicely. It's stopped wobbling. It helps that you've got the base of it full of honey. So to stop it from contacting the bottoms of the frames, I'm just gonna run that off, run a bucket off. I see a lot of people trying to strain straight out of the extractor. If you've got plenty of time, good on you. But I just get it out of the extractor into the settling tanks and then strain it before I bottle it. You'll see what I do later. So that's running out of there nicely. I'll pick it up, put it into the settling tub. Stick him up in there and let it drain out on that bucket drainer. So I can have two buckets going at the same time, and yeah, it's a pretty quick process. So that extractor's balanced up nicely now, and I can increase that speed quite quickly, and it's quite stable now. It's not going to move at all, so just got to get it through that unbalanced stage so all the frames are nice and even, and you can run that speed nice and high. I think sometimes when they're really unbalanced, I think it'll be a benefit to screw that extractor to the floor. Well, I'm a bit reluctant because I just like to be able to move it around, but yeah, I think I might still screw it to the floor. Yep, I'll see how I go. So that's running nicely now. These frames will come out really dry. Up to 85, that's as fast as I need to go. So there's our second bucket of honey out of that load. Let's tip him in. Let that drain out with the bucket emptier. So that'll hold 200 litres, and that wax will just float to the top over time. I keep the shed nice and warm. I'm also going to look at a tank warmer, a belt tank warmer for these things, just to keep them warm so they don't candy during the winter. So that's got that done. They've cleaned up really nicely. There's nothing left in them. What I do like to do is go through and get all the extra wax off these frames. They just fit back nicely into the hive. And wax is worth money, so just like to go and scrape the top and side bars and recover as much of that wax as I can. So they're coming out in reverse order, and they go back into the boxes in reverse order, so I maintain my barrier system. A lot of wax there. So that's the process. We'll get all these frames out, clean them up, and do it all again. So that's got everything done for the day. All those stickies are in the back of the ute, ready to go back on the bees tomorrow. So just the last of that honey draining out of that extractor there. There's probably a bucket left inside it. getting down to the bottom there. Takes quite a while to come out. There's all the cappings sitting in the uncapping bench, and you can just see that honey starting to seep up through the strainer there. So we'll probably get another bucket or two of honey off that. And that's the results of the day. I would say about, it's a 200 litre drum, so maybe 120, 130 litres of honey in there off 15 boxes, and they weren't sort of 100% full, so they're about 80% full. So next step is to get some into the bottling drum, and we'll bottle a few jars of honey and get them ready for sale. So a great example of why I use these tubs between the bucket and the floor. My partner just came in and said, "Darling, I need help with a horse and I need help right now." And I've just taken off and come back to this. So great example. You always get distracted when there's a honey tap open and off you go. And at least it's a couple hundred mils, and it'll make a little bit of a mess, but always put that tub under the bucket. So these wax cappings will just drain for a couple of days, and I'll just come in every day or so, every half a day, and just rake it over, turn it over and break it up so that all that honey runs out down into the under the tray and out the tap. We'll take the bucket off shortly. So let's see how that gets done. Yeah, so that's honey coming out of the uncapping bench. Just a bit of candy stuff there from the last extraction. So that'll run out. I expect to get a bucket out of that, and dribs and drabs out of it over the next few days. So yeah, nothing's wasted. So we've got this full up to about here. I reckon about, I don't know, where is it, about here. So I don't know, close to 160, 170 litres. The next step is to just get a bit of this off the bottom. I really prefer to leave it for a couple of days and all that wax comes to the top, but I need honey right now, so just drain a bit off. That's coming out pretty clear. There's a few particles of wax. If you leave it for a few days, that'll all rise to the top, and even with a belt warmer on it, that'll even come out. That wax will come out even quicker. So bit of manhandling in this process. It's just the way it is. Bigger producers have got stuff moving around in sumps and pumps, but yeah, I can't justify spending that money when I can lift a bucket. It's my bottling tank, so the jars go down here and I bottle straight in. This is the only time I strain honey, is into that bottling tank. So I've got this cool large strainer the other day from Hornsby Beekeeping Supplies, and that'll hold about a bucket of honey, so that just goes straight to there. I'll get up on this stand and put it in. It's pretty inelegant, so I won't film that. Yeah, we'll get some honey in here and start bottling. So bottling's a pretty simple process. Just loosen that off, fill my jar. This honey's almost candied from the other day. ml jar holds a kilo of honey, and everyone probably gets a little bit more than a kilo. Go through that process till we've got a dozen. So last step in the process, when we
needs a ladle. So, fantastic Arara Valley honey ladles. Just drop the jar over like that. I like to put a sticker over the top so it's tamper proof.